Now, speaking of technology, Chinese robotics stocks jumped this week after startup Unitree posted this video of its upgraded G1 robot showing off some swirling kung fu moves. The company says it's still upgrading its algorithms and the robot can learn any action at will. Shares of Wuxi Botan in particular surging 50% this week after holding talks with Unitree on using their robot technology. Joining us now is Jacqueline Du, head of China Industrial Technology Research at Goldman Sachs. Jacqueline, good to have you with us. Talk to us about, you know, the AI development, robotics development, humanoid robot development in China, especially in relation to the U.S.
Haslinda, thank you for having me. First of all, I have to say that for Goldman Sachs Global Investment Research, we have been closely monitoring the development of human robot early since 2022. And I want to say that we are very positive in terms of future outlook. And I think in the longer run, human robot development could be potentially very significant. If you think about potentially it may be the best embodiment of artificial intelligence technology. And into the next decade, we are expecting a $38 billion market size. And in the blue sky scenario, we are looking into $205 billion. So basically, if a human robot can potentially become an industry as big as electric vehicles or smartphones, that's the driving the swing from our base case to blue sky scenario. And that's likely to bring new growth opportunities globally and also including China. And especially in China, we have the manufacturing capability and also the hardware and software know-how. And I think that's likely to be an excellent playground for global investors to look for very big investment opportunities into the coming decades.
We've been talking about the massive opportunities in humanoid robot. It is a race. It is especially a race between the U.S. and China. Where are we with that? I mean, is the U.S. leading in a huge way?
I would say if you consider U.S. and also China, I think the two countries, first of all, they are driving the development of artificial intelligence technology development. And the two countries, I see them highly complementary to each other. Relatively speaking, U.S., they're pretty strong in terms of the AI front. If you think about the large language models, they are quite developed. Where in China, this is the world's factory. We have the hardware manufacturing capability, we have a big group of supply chain companies can be potentially the enablers of human robot. So I would say the two countries are very complementary to each other.
It is about real world cases. It is about how it can be commercialized. Where are we in that process? Is there anything that's viable currently?
Right. Technology viability, I think that that's the biggest question. And where when we consider 2025, I would say when we look at globally, the leading robot players in this field is still the shipment outlook is probably like a few thousand units for each of those leading players. And it's still primarily for R&D purpose and for training purpose and to further refine the human robot product. And it's still unclear yet whether this technology inflection point has already reached, that's still a question mark. Where in our recent report, I want to highlight that last week we published this latest report named The Supply Chain Dynamism. We define the inflection point in terms of technology. We think that we need a stronger evidence to see whether the robot can really doing useful tasks autonomously, efficiently, and with high robustness. And at the same time, they need to have quick reasoning to catch the pace of the production line. It's only when we see the product is ready, then we can get more comfortable in terms of the future outlook. Where if you consider the stock market year to date has already rallied 50 plus for several of the stocks I cover, I would say the public expectation and the stock market expectation probably is a little bit faster as compared to the real development progress. So we need to see the technology pace catching up to drive sustainable share price performance going forward.
Jacqueline, you talk about how we have yet to ascertain what the robots can do. Well, we know that it can suddenly do kung fu moves, as we've been showing to our viewers. I mean, how much progress does that signify, one, in terms of robotics, and how much progress does that signify in terms of China's own Gen AI capabilities?
Yeah. Well, let me give you a story. 15 months ago, when I visited those Chinese robot companies, I visited their robot labs. It's still hanging there. Basically, it cannot walk. It cannot do those fancy dancing movement. But this year, just this week on Wednesday, I visited them again. Now they can do the performance pretty robust. So you can tell the development progress is pretty fast, actually, even though it's not quite there yet. Where last year in January 2024, we had a report with the name AI Accelerant. That's how we think about the role, how artificial intelligence is important to the human robot industry development and why the speed is so fast. We think AI, that's the most important driver. And if you compare a human robot versus the traditional industrial robot, which is rule-based, which is a pre-programmed, but human robot is supposed to be a more generalized product. And the future goal for those leading robot players is to make it a general-purpose robot. So being autonomous and doing multiple tasks with a high generalization capability, that's enabled by artificial intelligence.
So it's moving at an accelerated pace. Progress has been pretty rapid. What still stands in the way of commercialization?
Well, for us, we are expecting $38 billion U.S. market size by 2035. And the rationale is, we think initially, it's still likely to be applied in, for example, industrial application scenarios, which is more, if you think about factory, is more structured environment, roughly simpler for the robot to handle certain tasks. And when we take a reference to industrial product in history, for example, if you think about the upper body of the human robot, that's basically collaborative robot, right? But considering the pace of AI development, which is new, and we think the pace is slightly faster than that. But 2030 beyond, within consumer application, that's the bigger market opportunity. And I think it's still some time away for those products to be really ready. But that's definitely the longer term opportunity.
How might the chip war between the U.S. and China impact development, especially in China's own robotic market?
If you consider the chips goes into the robot, we need a CPU plus GPU, and NVIDIA is an important enabler of the robotics technology as well. Where between U.S. and China, when investors consider the investment opportunity in the space, geopolitical risk is definitely a factor to consider. Where for investors to think about which is the stock to play, I would say, we would highlight that it's better to avoid some data critical areas. For example, sensors. It looks to me it's rather difficult for Chinese suppliers to potentially be the suppliers of the sensor component to the global brands. That's one thing. But at the same time, you can imagine in China, given we also have the AI capability, we have the manufacturing supply chain. So that also implies China may have our own robot leaders. So that's how I look at the tariff question.
So in a way, sometime down the road, you do see China becoming a supplier of robotic components. Is that a fair assumption?
at this stage, I would say the robotics component, that's the best investment opportunity for global investors, as it's more rational for those component company if they already have the existing product with the traditional application, where human robot is just adding a new applications, then it is relatively more, that's the investment area with a better risk reward for investor to look at it, because after what, anyway, human robot is a new industry, it's still at a very early stage, so component opportunity, I think that's where investors should go to at this stage.
We talk about the human robots, of course, sometimes you tend to think at some stage they may have a mind of their own. We saw some visuals of a robot attacking a crowd at a festival in China. How are you assessing the risks of these human robots?
Interesting question. Put into another way, we talk about the longer term opportunity is consumer application, right? And if you think about the human robot product, I think there's still several bottlenecks that we need to solve the problems. For example, safety, that's a big problem, right? If you look at those robot products, it's 60, 70 kg, is pretty heavy. So robustness, safety issue has to be solved. Then into the future, 2030 and even 2035 beyond, there's an opportunity for us to see human robot really working around us.
One final question, Jacqueline, before we let you go. Robots at home, you know, like how far away are we from having a robot with the family?
I think for a human robot, the potential demand is huge. The more important thing is whether technology is viable, right? And in terms of potential demand on the consumer application front, you can imagine, for example, household tasks, elderly care, and that's the potential area with demand. That's definitely there. It's more important about whether technology can really unlock that very significant demand potential. So that's the most important thing. And 10 years time horizon, we're looking into $38 billion market size. And if consumer application, the technology is progressing faster than our expectation, that will unlock a $205 billion market size. So that's the difference, and that's the opportunity.